मानव ज्ञान माध्यमिक विद्यालय र बुद्ध सामुदायिक टेलिभिजन को संयुक्त प्रयास में सञ्चालन भइरहेको एसीई तयारी विशेष कक्षा में यहाँहरुलाई स्वागत। म विज्ञान शिक्षक अमृत घिमिरे कालिका मानव ज्ञान माध्यमिक विद्यालय। विद्यार्थी भाई बहिनीहरु, यो भन्दा अगाडिको क्लास में हामीले दुईटा क्लास पढिसक्यौं र यो क्लास में हामीले एसआई युनिट्सहरु भ्यालुजहरु त्यसपछि हामीले लजहरु यो क्वेशनहरु हामीले केही डिस्कसन गरेका थियौं। आज हामीले गर्ने भनेको मैले अस्ति क्लास में लास्ट में भनिसकेको थिएँ, आज हामीले प्रूफ जति पनि हाम्रो साइन्समा प्रूफहरु छन् ती प्रूफहरु हामीले आज गर्दै छौं र हामी यही बाउन्ड्रीमै जति प्रूफ छ त्यही बाउन्ड्री भित्रै रहेर हामीले डिस्कसन गर्ने छौं। अब मैले प्रूफ द्याट फलोइङमा हामीले आज के प्रूफ गर्दै छौं भनेर चाहिँ एकचोटि म विद्यार्थी भाइहरुलाई फेरि सबै यो बताउन चाहन्छु। एकचोटि स्क्रिनमा हेरौँ त, हामीलाई स्टेट एन्ड प्रूफ न्युटन्स युनिभर्सल ल अफ ग्राभिटेसन अर प्रूफ, हामीलाई त्यो ल्याङ्ग्वेजमा पनि दिन सक्छ अथवा म्याथमेटिकल्ली, अर प्रूफ एफ इक्वल्स टु जी एम वन एम टू बाई टी स्क्वायर वेयर द सिम्बल्स ह्याभ द युजुअल मिनिङ्स भनेर यसरी सोध्न सक्छ। त्यसै गरी प्रुभ एफ इक्वल्स टु जी क्यापिटल एम स्मल एम डिभाइड बाई आर स्क्वायर द सिम्बल्स ह्याभ दियर युजुअल मिनिङ्स। सिमिलरली एफ इक्वल्स टु जी एमएम डिभाइड बाई आर प्लस एच होल स्क्वायर। यसैसँग रिलेटेड म्याथमेटिकल प्रुभहरू पनि आउँछ। सो वाट चेन्जेस विल अकर इन ग्राभिटेसनल फोर्स वेन बोथ द मासेस आर डबल बट डिस्टेन्स रिमेन सेम, बोथ द मासेस रिमेन सेम बट डिस्टेन्स इज डबल। Similarly, if the masses, both the masses are kept constant and distance is halved, or both the masses are halved and distance is halved, under different conditions my equation dina sakcha. Kei examples haru hamile padhne chhau. Yo examples haru garisakepachi hamile esai sanga related aune jati pani questions haru chhan telai garna sakne chhau. Similarly, arko question, prove that g equals to gm by r square, or g is proportional to, inversely proportional to r square, or acceleration produced on a freely falling body is independent of mass of the body. Prove gh equals to r by r plus h whole square into g. Generally, हामीले numerical problems or my encountered गर्ने formula हो, तर यो formula कसरी derive भएको छ आज त्यसको बारेमा हामीले discuss गर्ने छौं। Similarly, prove f1 by f2 equals to d2 square by d1 square. F can be also written as weight, so it can also be written as w1 by w2 equals to d2 square by d1 square. And also prove that hydraulic press is a force multiplier. यो प्रेसर च्याप्टरमा एउटा आइराख्ने क्वेसन, आज हामीले यो पनि गर्नेछौँ। त्यसै हामीले अर्को प्रुभ्स, प्रुभ द्याट क्यू इक्वल्स टु एमएस डिटी हिट च्याप्टरबाट, प्रुभ आई बाई ओ इक्वल्स टु बी बाई यू फर लेन्स फ्रम च्याप्टर लेन्स। सिमिलरली प्रुभ म्याथमेटिकल्ली द्याट स्टेप अफ ट्रान्सफर्मर अलवेज इन्क्रिजेस द इनपुट भोल्टेज। विद्यार्थी भाइ बहिनीहरूले यो लास्टको क्वेसन चाहिँ नयाँ जस्तो लाग्न सक्छ, तर यसलाई हामीले म्याथमेटिकल्ली स्टेप अफ ट्रान्सफर्मरले इनपुट भोल्टेजलाई आउटपुट भोल्टेजमा इन्क्रिज गर्छ भनेर कसरी प्रुभ गर्ने भनेर आज त्यो मैले एउटा अलिकति नयाँ खालको क्वेसनलाई पनि डिस्कसन गर्नेछु। विद्यार्थी भाइ बहिनीहरू, हामी सुरुकै प्रुभबाट जान्छौँ। म एकचोटि बोर्डमा गर्छु, हेरौँ है त। प्रुभ द्याट एफ इक्वल्स टु जी एम वन एम टू डिभाइड बाई डी स्क्वायर। अब यो प्रुभ गर्नको लागि हामीले के गर्नु पर्यो, न्युटन्स युनिभर्सल ल अफ ग्राभिटेसनको हेल्प लिनु पर्यो। हामीले सुरुमा लेख्नु पर्यो स्टेटमेन्ट। अब स्टेटमेन्ट हामीले अस्ति लास्टको क्लासमा पढिसकेका छौँ, स्टेटमेन्ट न्युटन्स युनिभर्सल ल अफ ग्राभिटेसनको। त्यसले के भन्छ, न्युटन्स युनिभर्सल ल अफ ग्राभिटेसन स्टेट्स द्याट द फोर्स अफ एट्र्याक्सन बिट्विन एनी टू मासेस इज डाइरेक्टली प्रोपोर्सनल टु द प्रोडक्ट अफ देयर मासेस एन्ड इन्भर्सली प्रोपोर्सनल टु द स्क्वायर अफ द डिस्टेन्स बिट्विन देयर सेन्टर्स। ओके, होइन, अब हामीले त्यही कुरालाई चाहिँ स्टेटमेन्ट पहिला सुरुमा लेख्नु पऱ्यो है त। न्युटन्स युनिभर्सल ल अफ ग्राभिटेसन स्टेट्स द्याट द फोर्स अफ एट्र्याक्सन बिट्विन एनी टू बडिज इज डाइरेक्टली प्रोपोर्सनल टु द प्रोडक्ट अफ द मासेस, त्यहाँ प्रोडक्ट छुटेछ, टु द प्रोडक्ट अफ द मासेस एन्ड इन्भर्सली प्रोपोर्सनल टु द स्क्वायर अफ द डिस्टेन्स बिट्विन देयर सेन्टर्स। यो चाहिँ हामीले पहिला स्टेटमेन्ट लेख्नु पऱ्यो। मैले बोर्डमा यो स्टेटमेन्ट चाहिँ लेख्दिनँ, अब म्याथमेटिकल के छ त्यहाँ म त्यो कुरालाई डिस्कस गर्छु। सो एकचोटि बोर्डमा हेर्ने, हामीलाई पहिला सुरुमा स्टेटमेन्ट हामीले लेख्नु पऱ्यो। अब मैले दुईवटा मास कन्सिडर गरिरहेको छु, लेट अस कन्सिडर टु मासेस एम वन एम टू, टु बडिज ह्याभिङ मासेस एम वन एन्ड एम टू एन्ड द डिस्टेन्स बिट्विन दिज टु मासेस फ्रम द सेन्टर। सो स्टेटमेन्टले भनेअनुसार, सो वी विल डु दिस डिस्टेन्स फ्रम द सेन्टर, लेट अस डिनोट इट बाई डी। नाउ अकॉर्डिङ टु द न्यूटन्स युनिभर्सल ल अफ ग्राविटेशन ग्राविटेशन मैथमेटिकली वी कैन राइट मैथमेटिकली वी कैन राइट एफ इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू एम वन इंटू एम टू एंड एफ इज इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू डी स्क्वायर. दिस इज फ्रॉम द स्टेटमेंट ऑफ द न्यूटन्स यूनिवर्सल लॉ ऑफ ग्रेविटेशन. सो लेट अस राइट दिस इक्वेशन वन एंड इक्वेशन टू. सो वी हैव टू राइट हियर वेयर डी इज द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन मासेस एम वन एंड एम टू. नाउ वी कैन कंबाइन दीज टू इक्वेशंस इक्वेशन वन एंड इक्वेशन टू. सो नाउ कंबाइनिंग इक्वेशन वन एंड इक्वेशन टू वी कैन राइट एफ इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू एम वन अपन एम टू बाय डी स्क्वायर. हामी यहाँसम्म आयौँ. अब यहाँ त हामीले कम्बाइन गरिसक्यो. अब यु टु रिमुभ द प्रोपोर्सनालिटी साइन वी अल नो द्याट वी मस्ट रिमुभ द प्रोपोर्सनालिटी साइन बाई इक्वल टु एन अ कन्स्ट्यान्ट भ्याल्यु. सो हियर एफ इक्वल्स टु जी एम वन एम टू डिभाइड बाई डी स्क्वायर. फाइनल्ली वी गेट द आन्सर विच वी हेभ टु प्रुभ. सी हियर सो दिस इज द फाइनल एक्सप्रेसन विच वी रिक्वायर्ड वेयर वेयर G is proportionality constant and what it is called is universal gravitational constant and its value is 6.67 into 10 to the power minus 11 unit newton meter square per kg square. So G is called is universal gravitational constant and its value is 6.67 into 10 to the power minus 11 unit newton meter square per kg square. So now we must know what is the definition of G. So how can you define G now? G can be defined as the force of attraction between the unit masses kept at a unit distance. So we can define the G from the equation we just have derived. That is F equals to G M1 M2 divided by D square. If both the masses are 1 kg and distance D is 1 meter, then the force of attraction between them is called as universal gravitational constant and its value is 6.67 into 10 power minus 11 Newton meter square per kg square. The numerical value of G, this capital G, the value of this capital G was experimentally determined by Henry Cavendish. Henry Cavendish was the person who discovered the numerical value of universal gravitational constant. So we must know another question here. Why the Newton's universal law of gravitation is also called as universal law? Why this law it is also called as universal law? Newton's universal law of gravitation is also called as universal law because it is true for all the bodies universally. It is true for small masses, big masses and similarly celestial and terrestrial bodies. So these were the proof, first proof which we have just completed. Now let us see the second question. The second question which we have to prove now. The second is F equals to GMM divided by R square. Now see on the board, please. On the board, I am going to prove the second equation. On the board. So this is the second equation which we are going to prove. So to prove this, the difference between the first equation and the second equation is that here we have written M1 and we have written this M2. This was previously written as D. So only the difference is M1 is replaced by capital M, M2 is replaced by small m, and D is replaced by R. So while deriving this equation, the difference is only that while drawing the figure we take care of. So let us consider first this question. Let us consider the mass of the planet, or let us say Earth. Let the mass of this planet be capital M. So let a small mass is lying on the surface of the Earth. Then at that time, the distance between the mass, small mass M, which is lying on the surface of the Earth, and from the center of the Earth, whose mass is capital M, be R. Then at that time, everything we have written previously is same, but only the difference is, now we are going to do this. Same, again, according to the Newton's law of gravitation, F is directly proportional to M into M. Previously, we have written M1 into M2. Previously, we have written M1 into M2. Okay, previously we have written M1 into M2. Now, F is directly proportional to M into M. This capital M is the mass of the Earth or any heavenly object or the planet. So, M is the mass of the body. Second, now, F is inversely proportional to R square, distance between the centers, according to the statement. So, combining these equation 1 and 2 again, equation 1 and 2 combining, F is directly proportional to M into M divided by R square. Now, removing the proportionality sign, F equals to GMM divided by R square. Again, now the second number equation is complete now. Second number equation we just completed. So, if you see here, difference between the first equation which we have proved and the second equation which we have proved is only in the terms of symbols. So, here M1 and M2 are the two different masses. Let us say they are on the surface of the Earth. So, this is the this is the force of attraction between the planet and mass of the object lying on the surface of the Earth. So, this is the second equation. So, while writing the derivations or proof, we must take care what we are considering. To prove this, we must So, small m is the mass of the body and R is the distance from the center, so that is R. Now, we are going to prove third one. So, you have to write the language also. Now, we have to prove the third equation. The third equation which we have to prove was, I'll write the third equation here. Third equation, that is F equals to GMM divided by R plus H whole square. This is the third equation we have to prove now. So, to prove third equation, it is similar to the equation first and second. हामीले फर्स्ट र सेकेन्डमा जे गर्यो सेम नै दियो तर डिफरेन्स अलिकति के छ यहाँ आर प्लस एच होल स्क्वायर छ सो वाइल प्रुभिङ दिस वी आर नट टेकिङ द अब्जेक्ट लाइङ अन द सर्फेस अफ द प्लानेट अर द अर्थ वी आर टेकिङ इट अवे एट अ डिस्टेन्स एच फ्रम द सर्फेस अफ द अर्थ नाउ इन फिगर इफ यु सी द फिगर यु क्यान डु इट क्लियरली नाउ सी हियर लेट अस से दिस इज द मास अफ अर्थ अर प्लानेट And a small mass is at a distance of h from here. Let this distance be r. We are in equation third. So, this distance here r, this distance is h. So, what we have to do to prove this is, we have to consider a small mass is lying above the surface of the earth at height h. So, at that time, if we see from the statement of Newton's universal law of gravitation, F equals to m into m. So Newton's universal law of gravitation states that it is the product of the masses, mass of the planet and mass of the body. Now, second, what does the second part say? It says that it is inversely proportional to the square of the distance between their centers. So, from here to here, from here to here, what is the distance here? The distance from here to here is r. The distance from here to here is h. So, the total distance will be r plus h, r plus h. So, it is 1 by r plus h whole square, 1 by r plus h whole square. Okay. Now, what we do? We again combine these equation 1 and 2. But remember that, student, please, you have to write the language also. I am escaping the language here. You have to write the language also. I have already written equation first. So, you have to write the language also. So, combining equation 1 and 2. Now, F is proportional to m into m by r plus h whole square. Again, the last step, we have to put a constant here. So, mm by r plus h whole square. So, this is the equation which we require. So, third equation we proved. So, we proved three equations here. I will just recall here, once here. We proved F equals to g m1 m2 divided by d square. We also proved F equals to g mm by r square. We also proved F equals to g mm by r plus h whole square. So, you think the equation same method bada prove garne? Tara difference ke bhayo? If the difference is only in the figures. So, while proving this, we will consider two masses m1 and m2. Distance between them is d. So, to prove this, we must consider a planet or the earth whose mass is m, and a small mass is lying on the surface of the earth. Distance between them is r. To prove the third one, we must consider that this small mass is at a height h from the surface of the earth. So, for the third question, the figure will be like this. This is r, this is m, and this is small m. So, this is the height from the surface of the earth where this m is present. So, we have completed three derivations. So, only the difference, remember again, only the difference is in terms of the figure. Other thing, everything we are writing is same as equation 1. Now, we are going to prove fourth question. So, sometimes you are asked what changes will occur in the gravitational force if the masses or the distances are changed. So, see there, fourth one. What changes will occur in gravitational force when both the masses are double but distance remains same, both the masses remain same but distance is double, both the masses are halved and distance is also halved. So, we get a different variety type of questions here. We can create a lot of questions here, but I will teach you the pattern how to do this. So, to do this, let us consider the first one. Both the masses are double but the distance remain same. What changes will occur in gravitational force? So, the condition is when both the masses are doubled and distance is constant. That means we are not changing the distance. Distance remain the same. So, look on the board, please. When the masses are double and distance is constant. So, question is this. we have to find out what change will occur on the gravitational force. So previously we must know that when the gravitational force between any two masses m1 m2 is kept at a distance, when the masses are kept at a distance d, then the gravitational force will be, we know the equation we just derived, that is F equals to g m1 m2 divided by d square. That means when these two masses are at a distance d, so previously this is the equation, or that is the force of attraction between these two masses. Now the conditions when these distances are changed, when these distances, that means distance is constant but the masses are changed, the values of masses are changed now. So now we have to know, we have to write in this way. I will write one question and then we will do second and third similarly. So let masses m1 and m2 are at a distance d from the centers. So let the masses m1 and m2 are at a distance d from the centers. So masses are at a distance d from the centers, m1 and m2. Now we know the gravitational force. We know gravitational force is F equals to g m1 m2 divided by d square. We all know that. We have just proved this relation also. Now see here, according to the condition, now we input the condition here. According to the condition, the masses are doubled, both the masses are double and the distance is constant. That means the masses m1 now becomes 2m1. The new masses, that means mass is changed, so the new masses is 2m2 because both the masses are double. So another condition for the distance is kept constant, distance do not change. If the masses, values of the masses are changed, then obviously since gravitational force is directly proportional to the masses, that is product of the masses, if the values of masses are changed, the force of attraction will also be changed. So now new gravitational force is given by F nu, because this is the new gravitational force. So we cannot write F here because F is already g m1 into m2 divided by d square. So this F will be the new one. So F nu equals to, so g into 2m1 into 2m2 divided by d square, since the distance is unchanged or it is a constant. Now see here, we get this is 4 g m1 m2 divided by d square. So if we see, let's consider this as equation 1, then this value from equation 1 can be written as this. So what we see finally here, the new gravitational force according to this condition, under this condition, that is the both masses are double and distance is constant, the new gravitational force will be 4 times the older gravitational force, or four times the value of F, that is old force of attraction between these two masses initial. So the new force of attraction will be 4 times the old force of attraction. So this is the one question. So हामीले सेकेन्ड कन्डिसनको क्वेसनमा चाहिँ अब मैले अघि भनिसकेँ, सेम अदर प्रोसेस आर सेम, ओन्ली द कन्डिसन इज डिफरेन्ट. नाउ इफ द क्वेसन सेज वेन द बोथ, द्याट मिन्स वेन बोथ द मासेस आर कन्स्ट्यान्ट, लेट अस से क्वेसन सेज द्याट मासेस आर कन्स्ट्यान्ट, masses are constant and distance is
half.
Distance is half. This is the condition now. So we will write everything similar. Let us let masses m1 and m2 are at a distance of distance d from the centers. Then we know the gravitational force will be this. Only the difference is in the condition. So at this condition, the masses, both the masses are constant. Masses remains unchanged, but distance is halved. So we have to reduce this distance by half. Now what we do? The new gravitational force will also be changed now. So masses are constant. So masses will be constant. Only it changes is distance. So distance only changes. So it will be d by 2 whole square. So that means d square by 4. So this 4 goes again above and it is same. The answer will be same. Only the condition is different, that is the masses are double and distance is halved. So similarly, other questions also we can do in same manner. We can do in same manner. Let us see the third question now. Question 4, third. What was the third question? Let us see the condition there. The condition was distance, that means, sorry, masses are, the masses are double and the distance is, masses are double, distance is, I think, constant. Let us see the slide there. Question 4. Question number 4, C. These are the questions we will do later on, after proving the fourth one. So see there, both the masses are halved and distance is also halved. Now the condition is masses are also halved and distance also halved. So what happens here? Let us see on the board. I am not rubbing this from the board, but we will do there. See on the board, both the masses are halved and distance is also halved. So here, both the masses are halved. I am just changing the values here. Masses are halved and distance is also halved. Masses is halved, distance is also halved. So everything is similar. Only the difference is in the condition. So according to the condition, masses are halved, distance also halved, distance also halved. Now again the new gravitational force will be same. M1 by 2, M2 by 2. Now let us see here. G into M1 by 2 into M2 by 2 divided by D square by 2. So what happens here? 2 to the 4, sorry, here is 4. 2 to the 4, 4 and 4 cancel each other. So that will be G M1 M2 divided by D square. F nu equals to G M1 M2 divided by D square. So what does this gives here? From equation 1, we can write this as, we can replace this as F old. Therefore, F nu will be equal to F old. That means the new force of attraction remains unchanged. It is similar to that of old. So the new force of attraction remains unchanged. So we have proved 4 equations here. Now let us go to the fifth one. Okay, the fifth one. Prove that G equals to Gm by R square. This is an important one. It usually asks in questions also. Prove G equals to Gm by R square, or G is inversely proportional to R square, or acceleration, in language also it can be given, or acceleration produced on a freely falling body is independent of mass of the body. So how to prove this? Let us see here. Everything is similar. Now see here. Prove G equals to Gm by R square, or G is inversely proportional to R square. So how to prove this? Let us see here on the board. To prove this, we have to consider a heavenly object, that means a planet whose mass is m, and a small mass is lying on the surface of the earth or planet. So now we again consider this as a distance from the centers that is equal to the radius. Now see here, we know from the Newton's universal law of gravitation, what we know, if small mass is m is lying on the surface of the earth, F will be equal to g capital M small m divided by r square. We have already proved this also. Now, to prove this relation, we must know this force is also equal to the weight of the body. This force is also equal to the weight of the body. We know that F equals to mg, which is also equals to W. And this force or this weight is for the mass, small mass that is lying on the surface of the earth. So now see here, this F can be written as F equals to mg equals to g m divided by r square. So we can cancel this. Now we can write g equals to gm by r square. So hence proved. If you are asked only to prove up to here, this is proved. But remember that I am not writing the language here. You have to write the language also here. You have to put the language also. You have to write that let us consider a planet having the mass m on which the small mass m is lying on the surface, the radius of the planet be r. So you have to write the language, everything. You have to write the language, and the mathematical part is only this. So hence this is proved now. So simple. So after this, to prove this, you can be asked this or this. This and this is same thing, but only one step. This g and m, g is a universal gravitational constant. It is a constant value. This m, capital M, is the constant value. It is the mass of the particular planet. So this will also be a constant. Mass will be constant. So this g and m both are constant. So we can remove the constant sign. We can remove the constant sign and put a proportionality sign there. So g equals to, g proportional to, inversely proportional to r square, where g and m are constants. G and m are constants. So this equation also proved. Now, in language it is written. So what does this equation reveals? What does this equation say? This says that acceleration due to gravity is independent of the mass of the body. It only depends upon the mass of the planet and the radius of the planet, but it do not depends upon the mass of the body, that is small m. It do not depends upon the mass of the freely falling body. It only depends upon the mass of the planet or radius of the planet. This g is a constant. So from here we can also write is acceleration due to gravity, hence acceleration due to gravity is independent of the mass of the body. So this also proved. We have proved the another equation also. So now let us go to the another equation which we have to prove. The sixth one, we have completed five. The sixth one. What is the sixth equation? Prove gh equals to r by r plus h whole square into g, where the symbols have their usual meanings. So this equation is generally not asked to derive, but we must know how it is derived because it is used in the numerical problems. So let us see here. What is the equation? Gh equals to r by r plus h whole square into GE. The symbols have their usual meanings. It means that, see on the board, GH. This is the acceleration due to gravity at certain height. This is the radius of the planet. This GE is the acceleration due to gravity. Okay, so now see on the board, please. So now see here, we know that I'm not writing the language here. Once again, I'm just writing the mathematical part here. We know that we have just derived an equation, that is g equals to gm by r square. We have just proved it. So by taking the help of this equation, we are going to prove this. Now see here, let us consider m, this is the capital M, m is the mass of planet having radius r, then the equation of acceleration due to gravity can written as g equals to gm by r square. So let us represent this by ge. This is equation 1. Now for this we must consider this figure, that is mass m. Small mass is lying on the surface of the earth, distance between them r, acceleration due to gravity is given by g equals to gm by r square. This is equation 1. Now if this same mass lies at a certain height h, let us see another figure. So when this small mass lies at height h at a distance r, at that time what will be the value of g? Now acceleration due to gravity, when mass m is at height h from the surface of planet, let us say planet, at that time gh will be given by gm by r plus h whole square. This is equation 2. So this is equation 2. So what we do, we divide equation 2 by equation 1. Now see here, dividing equation 2 by 1. So what we get here, gh by ge equals to gm by r plus h whole square divided by gm by r square. So when we divide equation 2 by 1, we get this. Now this gm and gm cancel each other. So what is the remaining now? Gh by ge equals to r square by r plus h whole square. Okay, so the last step, now gh equals to r square by r plus h whole square into ge. Therefore, gh equals to r by r plus h whole square into ge. Hence, this is the required equation which needed to be proved. So, okay. Now, from this equation, we must know something. The value of r plus h and r, let us compare. The value of r plus h is always greater than r. The value of r plus h is always greater than r. So, if the value of r plus h is always greater than r, what will be the value that is r divided by r plus h? Will it be greater than 1? Will it be less than 1? Or will it be equal to 1? If you see here, The numerator value is low. The denominator value is high. So low value divided by high value. Low value divided by high value. What will be? Will it be greater than 1? Will it be less than 1? Will it be equal to 1? Let us see the example here. 4 divided by 5. 5 divided by 10. That means the numerator value is low, denominator value is high. So low value divided by high value. The ratio will always be less than 1. Okay? So now we can see here the value of R plus H is greater than R. So the ratio of R by R plus H will always be less than 1. So from here, what we can say, the value of accession due to gravity goes on decreasing as we move above the surface of the earth. The value of accession due to gravity goes on decreasing as we move above the surface of the earth. It is because the ratio of this R by R plus H is always less than 1. Less than 1 value divided by GE will always be less than GE. So GH will be always greater. That means, smaller. So GE will be always greater. That means the value of accession due to gravity goes on decreasing as we move above the surface of the earth. So this equation also completed. So we have completed just equation 6, I think. Now let us see the another one. Equation 6 completed. So what is the next equation? Equation 7. Equation 7 is to prove, this also comes generally in numerical problems, but we must know how this equation is derived. So F1 by F2 equals to D2 square by D1 square, or W1 by W2 equals to D2 square by D1 square. So now see here, F1 by F2 equals to D2 square by D1 square. So what we see here is the relation between only the gravitational force and the distance. That means here the masses must be constant. If the masses are constant and only distance is changed. So this equation suggests that the masses are constant but the distance is changing. So let us see how to do this. Once again I repeat, you must write the language also. I am skipping the language part here. So see here. Let us consider two masses, M1 and M2, are at a distance d from the centers. Let us say these are d1, the first distance. So what happens, the gravitational force here during this condition? We already know that F equals to g M1 M2 divided by d1 square. F equals to g M1 M2 divided by d1 square. Previously we have written d only because the distance was represented by d. Now the distance is d1. So this is equation 1. I just repeated that the masses are kept constant here. This equation shows clearly. Masses are constant, only the distance is changing because the relation between F and d only. So we have to change this distance. This can be increased also, this can be decreased also. Let us increase the distance between them. You have to write the language part here. The distance is changed here. Let us increase the distance. If we increase the distance value of the distance will also be changed. That is d2. Distance from the centers. These are the same masses. The values of the masses are not changed. Masses are constant. Now at this time, what will be the equation? That is force subtraction between them. F equals to g M1. M2 divided by d2 square. Previously it was d1, now it is a d2. It is equation 2. But here we have to say this force was for the distance d1. So this is the first force F1. This is F2 because it is for the distance d2. Now dividing equation 1 by 2, see here, dividing equation 1 by 2, F1 by F2 equals to जी एम वन एम टू डिवाइड बाई डी वन स्क्वेयर डिवाइड बाई जी एम वन एम टू डिवाइडेड बाई डी टू स्क्वायर. सिंस जी एम वन एम टू कैंसिल इच अदर सीयर दे कैंसिल इच अदर सो दैट मीन्स डी टू स्क्वायर बाई डी वन स्क्वायर एफ वन बाई एफ टू इक्वल्स टू डी वन स्क्वायर बाई सॉरी डी टू स्क्वायर बाई डी वन स्क्वायर. सो दिस इज प्रूव्ड. सो वट वी नाउ हैव इक्वेशन. इफ यू सी द इक्वेशन वी हैव ऑल्सो रिटन डब्ल्यू वन बाई डब्ल्यू टू दैट मीन्स दिस फोर्स कैन ऑल्सो बी रिटन इज वेट. सो दिस कैन ऑल्सो बी रिटन इज डब्ल्यू वन बाई डब्ल्यू टू इक्वल्स टू डी टू स्क्वायर बाई डी वन स्क्वायर. सो वी कंप्लीटेड अराउंड सेवन डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ प्रूफ्स. सो वी विल अगेन नेक्स्ट टाइम कंप्लीट द रिमेनिंग क्वेश्चंस. दिस वॉज फॉर टुडे. थैंक यू. प्रविधि में सहयोग करने प्राविधिक मित्र और सुभाष सिंह सरलाई विशेष धन्यवाद दिदै म यहाँबाट बिदा हुन चाहन्छु. अबको क्लास इंग्लिश. धन्यवाद.